Justin Pipe has fought back against Dave Chisnall to take the match on the deciding leg. He's booked himself a second round match against Peter Snakebite Wright tomorrow night. Well, Justin took half of his 12 chances here in Glasgow tonight. Chizzy taking just a third of his, but the key ones. He had two match darts, which he failed to convert. And Justin took advantage. That should be a tasty one tomorrow night, shouldn't it? Against Peter Wright. Now, 23-year-old Belgian Dimitri Vandenberg next. He would have been disappointed with a 6-1 defeat on home turf last week. But he showed what he can do by beating Andy Hamilton. Kim Huybrex and Brendan Dolan will qualify for tomorrow night. And next up, we have got Max Hopp, a wild card from Germany, against Adrian Lewis, who we didn't get to see in the European Championship last weekend. He didn't qualify for that, but he'll look to show us just how much his practice has put him back into good form. Let's see how he is. Here's John.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the action, coming to you from Glasgow, Scotland! And the Ladbrokes World Series of Darts Finals, all brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. Live on ITV Sport, and at this time, we welcome the millions of viewers joining us from around the world. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to meet the players. Ladies and gentlemen, the Maximizer, Max Hopp, and Jeff Hopp, Adrian.
Over in the commentary box for the next few matches, Alan Warren a little and Stuart Pike, who's a man who's seen every single dart thrown around the world this year, and he's got the air miles to prove it. Evening, Stuart.
Yes, thanks, Jackie. Enjoyed every minute of it as well. Hopefully Adrian Lewis, from his point of view, will enjoy it as well. He's got a huge couple of months coming up. Lewis and Max Hopp have both had difficult years, haven't they, Alan?
Yes, they certainly have. We need to see a little bit more from Adrian. He needs to get back to that top table and one of the top players in the world, but he needs to prove it.
Yeah, there he is. He missed the European Championship, didn't qualify. And as it stands at the moment, Adrian Lewis could be out of the world's top 16 after the Alexandra Palace and the World Championship. Hasn't qualified as yet for the Grand Slam either. It's been a tough year away from darts as well for Adrian. So too for Max Hopp, who, you know, we all expected to make giant strides this year, but it just hasn't happened for the German ace, has it?
No, he seems to have been around for quite some time, despite his youthful looks, but just hasn't really moved on. Obviously won the World Youth Championships a couple of years ago, and that was the moment we thought he might start making his move. Obviously a regular on the European Tour, most of the balls in Germany. Just maybe feeling the pressure a little bit, certainly not just from his fans, but as the German number one.
Well, Adrian Lewis here.
177!
As you can hear from George Noble, with the perfect start, brilliant 177. Now, is that AD setting his stall out?
Well, we talk about settling when you get on that big stage straight away. That'll certainly settle him down. Let's see how the practice in the back room, getting himself ready for this moment.
60.
Good start. Well, because he's missed tournaments as well, though, Alan, he's put himself under pressure, hasn't he? And you know,
well, it's not just the odd one either. He's missed quite a few, so he knows that.
But, 59.
He's got a little bit of time to try and make up for it, but he's going to have some really good results.
And of course, with Rob Cross getting to the final of the European Championship in Belgium last weekend, that knocked Adrian out of the Grand Slam of Darts. So unless AD reaches the final here in Glasgow this weekend. 140. He'll have to go to the Grand Slam qualifiers on Monday night, won't he?
Yes, he certainly will. That follows the World Youth Championships on Monday in Robin Park in Wigan. Big weekend over there. Big weekend up here as well.
Well, for me, Max Hopp has just got the perfect throw as well.
And, you know,
just disappointing for so many that he hasn't been able to take that next step. Tops then for Lewis. A chance for the German. Lewis started so well with a 177, but Hopp has stayed in there in this opening leg. That's a beauty. Double 16. Wow, how about that? 108 from Max Hopp. Adrian Lewis started with three perfect darts. But one missed dart and a double. And Lewis is already in trouble.
Yes, nice 15 dart leg. Wonderful finish from Hopp. From Adrian's point of view, when you start the leg with 177, 12 more darts and you don't win the leg. That's maybe lack of match practice, possibly, Stuart. I know it's only the first leg. Just that sharpness. We talk about sharpness. A lot of players who play on the Pro Tour and European Tour, they're the ones that get into the later stages of the TV tournaments now, as we saw last weekend.
Well, Adrian, year he's had, of course, good news is he's become a father again and away from the hockey. He had surgery on his back in the summer. He had problems with his kidneys during the Premier League. And his wife has also been in hospital, not been well this year, and it's been tough for him. You know, more important things in life than darts, and you know, Adrian has now got to refocus.
100. You've got to put your foot on there, Stuart, because he's got the rest of the year, some big tournaments coming up, and then start again in January. You know, he's got a big year ahead, wants to play more of the Pro Tour events, more of the European Tour events. He has to as well, just to get his sharpness back. We know how good he is. He can still produce fantastic darts, just not as consistently as he can with darts like these. He's got a 177. That's the first maximum.
If ever the phrase form is temporary, class is permanent, in this world of darts at the moment, it would apply to Adrian Lewis. Chops again, this time the same result. It goes high, too high. It's a double world champion. Ooh, just got the slightest kiss off the barrel, didn't it? We took it out of the treble.
Both did a double loon. It's close, but not close enough. So a decent leg there from Lewis. Against the throw.
There's his darter to break. Of course, on the World Series, Adrian Lewis not involved this year, but he won in Auckland in 2015. 96. Max Hopp made his World Series debut in Vegas. Also played in Germany. Düsseldorf lost first 96. Round both times.
Yeah, he's such a good professional, is Max. He's one of those players that everybody likes, 60. And maybe needs to get a little bit of a mean streak.
Is it fair to say that his career has stalled, or was that a bit harsh?
Fantastic darts there from Hopp. He gets his first maximum. I wouldn't say stall, Stuart. I just don't think he's got going. Still a young man, let's not forget that. Still got plenty of time, he's had a lot of experience on the big stage. He's been in the World Series, as you mentioned. He's played in the World Championships. Plays on most of the European tours in the big arenas, in front of the big crowds. The World Cup as well, obviously, in Germany. See, to revel in that, didn't he?
Well, that was it. I mean, the only quarter-final that Max Hopp has reached on the tour all year was helping Germany to the quarter-finals of the World Cup of Darts back in June in Frankfurt. Individually, it's been a really disappointing 2017. But a win over Adrian Lewis here would put a lot of the wrongs right.
Oh, that would have been 15 consecutive breaks of throw. Still got another chance though.
94.
Needs to tidy up.
It's like 9 for double 8.
Darts.
So it is three consecutive breaks of throw at the start of this match. The winner, of course, will play Michael van Gerwen, seeded 2. Gary Anderson, the top seed, after winning in Dubai and Perth in the World Series. But Michael van Gerwen winning both World Series finals here in Glasgow over the last couple of years. So the winner to take on the defending champ.
Yes, two fantastic finals the last 2 years, both over Peter Wright, 11-10 and 11-9 respectively. Oh, he's scoring well, he's Hopp. Back 140s.
It's a good point that you make, Adrian Lewis, fantastic player, but you can practice all you like, but nothing, you know, will come close to replicating an actual match on the big TV stages.
You get the odd players who can kind of get away with it. Top Phil Taylor over the years didn't play every Pro Tour event. Possibly Gary Anderson now. When you go past that, all these other players need to keep sharp, need to play on all the Pro Tour events, but certainly most of them.
Double 12. Should be a good guide for him.
60.
Well, he'll have another crack at it.
Yeah, it's always good to get it with the visit, isn't it? Oozes you with confidence for the remainder of the match.
100.
And you don't want to give your opponent any chance on the hockey, any further turns to get themselves going. I can't afford to miss though, with Lewis hovering.
Good
last out there. Second out rather. Right, the first hold of throw. Max Hopp looking good, 3-1 ahead. Lewis needs to respond.
Easy one.
Lewis, as it stands, fifth in the world. And he's defending money at Minehead at the Players' Championship. And Hopp is playing as well as we've seen Max Hopp play in a TV event for a long, long time. 97.5 average.
23.
Yeah, Lewis also defending runners-up at the World Championship. Hence the possibility that if it doesn't go well for him, he'd go tumbling down those world rankings.
60.
Yes, just that
too
bit,
good a player.
Little bit of added pressure. Because well, he'll be aware of it, and everybody will mention it as well.
Yeah,
just like
absolutely.
But he certainly will be aware. Oh, words fail me.
The system goes, the two-year system. Reputations count for now. You've got to be informed, and you've got to play well, and you've got to maintain your ranking.
Isn't by coincidence, Stuart, the players who are playing well on the Pro Tour and European Tour are winning the events or getting to the later stages. Yes, you've got Michael van Gerwen, who's the number one in the world and wins most events.
What a chance
there
here
for Max Hopp.
Take a 4-1 lead against Adrian Lewis. Double 8. Kiss the wire. Yeah, kissed it again where it mattered, inside the wire. And Adrian Lewis did a whole lot of bother in the first round here at the World Series. He's got to focus, he's got to find his A game. If Max Hopp is and has, the German leads 4-1. Welcome back to the opening night of the third staging of the World Series Finals. Michael van Gerwen winning the first two, and Michael van Gerwen will face the winner of this intriguing clash between the young German Max Hopp and Adrian Lewis. Lewis did not leave the stage during the break. Practice, but he's 4-1 down. Hopp with the darts to make it 5-1. And Adrian Lewis here in danger of an ignominious exit on the opening night at the Braehead Arena.
Yes, and he would have been red hot favourite for this match. Max Hopp is producing some fantastic darts. Maximum 177. 13 darts and that 108 finish in the first leg.
Well, it's now or never for Adrian, it really is. He has the class to stamp some authority, to go on a run of four or five legs, and that's what he needs desperately. We'll have to come down after that first dart, though, to some good effect.
Well, two good visits. And Lewis. Hopp is hanging in there.
99.
One trouble with every visit, you're going to be very difficult to beat, certainly when you're throwing first. Well, missed a switch down for 19s.
59.
Single 20 would have left a bogey number.
Well, as it stands, Adrian is heading to Wigan for the Grand Slam qualifiers on Monday. 100 pro tour card holders battling out for 8 places in the Grand Slam at Wolverhampton. Starts next weekend.
Go from 167. Well, that's not a good second dart.
People have been asking on social media. We mentioned that Rob Cross getting to the final of the Europeans meant that Adrian Lewis dropped out of the Grand Slam automatically. If somebody else reached the final here, who would be next on the list? Well, the answer is Michael Smith and then Mark Webster. They are the next two in the danger zone. But very much in danger at the moment is Adrian Lewis.
Oh, two sloppy visits from Adrian. He's left Max Hopp, 108, which he took out in the first leg. They stay there. Had options for treble 16, but staying upstairs.
56.
You feel here, Adrian, this has to go. He may go for double-double. He did. He went for double 18 and tops.
38.
Max Hopp here to go 5-1 up against Adrian Lewis. Tops he needs. Use that dart superbly.
It's the third time, I think, Stuart, possibly fourth.
Last dart
with the last dart in his hand.
Absolutely.
That makes such a difference. It really does. Certainly for the player behind.
81.
But I just thought Lewis, because he hadn't got himself going at the ball route for the 94, would have been a better option. It's easy to say that after he's thrown. He felt confident enough to go for the treble 18. Didn't hit it or the double. Just not got himself going, he's got that spark.
Well, he started with a 177, you thought, well, here we go.
I thought exactly the same, Stuart. I really did.
But he missed a dart. Just one dart at tops to win that opening leg on throw. And Hopp taking out 108, and it seemed to change the whole mood of the match, didn't it?
Yeah, to be fair to Hopp, he's played pretty well. What he's done, as I mentioned, three or four of the legs he's won, he's hit it with the last dart and not let Adrian back to the board.
Taking his chances, Alan.
That's what it's all about. So that's a show and doubles for Doe. Somebody once said.
97.
Again, that first dart dropping beneath the treble.
60.
Doesn't give him a lot to go at.
And he's still left himself a lot of work to do.
Nice switch.
97.
Two big finishes available. 160 for Lewis. Now, just got to set it up. It's a bit awkward, that's first dart. And again, That's bounce on the wire. The following two are quite a bit away off.
We'll look to lose 64.
60. Aging your ball out 100.
May look at tops here.
Yeah, and another one, Adrian.
Well, they've just sparked it into life. Wonderful finish from Adrian Lewis. That's one down, four to go.
Well, that's Adrian Lewis down to a T, isn't it? Just when you think things aren't happening, he can produce something. 60. He hasn't done it consistently throughout the match, that's why he's behind 5-2. Cliche of leg by leg. His scoring just hasn't been there.
That's exactly what Justin Pike did in our second match of the night here. If you're just joining us, Simon Stevenson, a winner over Jan Dekker, and Justin Pike beating Dave Chisnell in a deciding leg. Chizzy was 5-3 up, missed two match darts, and Pike came back to win 3 on the spin.
It's a decent game, that one. Tube and Frode.
423.
Just noticeably see Adrian there steadying himself just before the throw. Just doesn't look comfortable. Probably most of that is due to the fact he's not playing particularly well. Still digging in there though.
I have to switch, surely.
49.
Didn't want that result though. And he's dropped the dart and he drags himself back.
Well, my top hasn't had the best of legs on throw. He was only 14 points behind. It was an opportunity for Lewis.
58.
Well, Hopp here is probably looking at the finishing line and he's gone off the boil, certainly. So a chance here for Adrian to get another leg back.
100.
He's trying to put some doubts in the mind of the German.
Well, we saw Matt top there. Sharp intake of breath, trying to keep his composure. Not at the treble, staying up there though, surprisingly. Number for 18s.
And another.
128.
Oh, a poor scoring leg. With a great setup from Lewis.
Battling away here, Lewis.
Well, sometimes you need to do that, Stuart.
85.
You know, you're not playing well, you've just got to battle your way through it. It's all about match play darts. Double two. Oh, Adrian.
Well, will they be the last darts that Adrian Lewis throws here in Glasgow this year? For the match. Double 10 for Max Hopp to complete one of his best wins of the year. For Adrian Lewis, he has much to think about over the next month or so. Lewis out of the World Series, falling at the first hurdle. And it's Max Hopp who will go through to play the defending champion, Michael van Gerwen, on Saturday night here in Glasgow.